the lectures on surveying too. In today's lecture, we will learn about the photogrammetric surveys. Again, we will try to write the definition the same way. These are the photographs taken from the camera in the air station with the axis of camera truly vertical. What is the condition here? The axis of camera should be truly vertical. The definition can be written of this vertical photograph, that these are the photographs taken from the camera in the air station with the axis of camera keeping truly vertical. That is what the vertical photograph. What here we can, as we are keeping, we are saying that it will be exactly vertical. So this is the lens of the camera and it is exactly vertical, then it will cover the certain, it will take the image of certain ground, and as it is kept exactly vertical, whatever image will be taken or whatever image will be captured, it will represent the map to very, it will represent a very close map, isn't it? The image, so that the image which is taken from this image is very close to map. As well as where we can use this vertical photograph, we can use it either for topographical service, or we can use it for the engineering service also. We can see the application of this vertical photograph, as the images whatever captured using this vertical photograph, they are very close to, they are very near to the exact map or real map. So these images are, can be used for the topographical service, as well as we can use it for the engineering service also. Next is object photograph. What is that? Here, the axis of camera is intentionally tilted. That is what the main important point. So how we will define this object photograph? These are the photographs taken from the camera in the air station with intentionally keeping the axis of camera tilted, tilting the axis of camera so that it will cover, what is the point? It is cover the large area. That is what the point, it will cover the large area. But as it is covering the large area and as we are tilting the axis of camera, what will happen? It will reduce the clarity. And on the basis of its tilting, on the basis of degree of tilting, it can be further classified into two categories. That is, one is low oblique photograph, another one is high oblique photographs. One is low oblique, another one is high oblique photograph. What is that? It means the axis of camera will be tilted in such a way that horizon is not visible in the photograph. In this, the the axis of camera is tilted in such a way that the origin is generally not visible in the photograph. That is what the low oblique photograph. Why? In the high oblique photograph, the origin will be visible. Origin is visible. Here the origin is not visible. Why? Here the origin is visible. So this is what the low oblique photograph. Why? The high oblique photographs. Or to say the suitability of this air photography, or to say this photography takes the train, in what situation it is suitable, or where it is unsuitable. So first of all, we'll see the suitability of this. In what circumstances it is suitable? It is suitable for topographical survey. It is suitable for topographical survey, then it is suitable for engineering surveys also. Or where we can prefer it? We can prefer it for the high degree of the projects where the high degree of accuracy is required. Places where high degree of accuracy is required, and those places also we can use this, as well as it can be used for, for the contouring of all sorts of mountainous and hilly terrain. Or to prepare the contours of, or to prepare the contour of this type of terrain, we can prefer the photogrammetric survey. Where it is unsuitable? The unsuitability of this one point, it is unsuitable for the survey of dense forest. Unsuitable for the survey of dense forest, one thing, then where the flat sand is available, because it is difficult to find out the control points. Therefore, we generally don't prefer this photographic for this photogrammetric survey for this kind of, for the surveying of dense forest as well as where the flat sand is available. We generally not prefer the photogrammetric survey as well as for the contouring or for the survey of flat terrain. For this type of situations, we really don't prefer the photogrammetric survey. Where we prefer, it is suitable for topographical survey, it is suitable for the engineering survey, it is suitable for the projects to adopt where the high degree of accuracy is required, as well as for the survey of mountainous and hilly terrain, as well as to prepare the contour in mountainous and hilly terrain, we can prefer this photogrammetric survey. Why? It is unsuitable for the dense forest as well as for the flat sand area, because it is difficult to get the control points in that as well as to recognize the points. So generally we don't prefer this photogrammetric survey for these areas, as well as we generally don't prefer it for the flat terrains. Photographs, tolerant is, what is this? It is the photoelastic taken from the air station with keeping with the axis of camera vertical or nearly vertical. This is what the vertical photograph, that means with the axis of camera vertical or it's nearly vertical, then here tilted photograph, what it is? It is the axis of camera is allowed should not the tilt of axis of camera, better to write in this way, tilt of axis of camera should not be should be less than 3 degrees. That means it should not be more than, in any case, 3 degrees, and the same thing, that the tilt should be always less than 3 degrees. Then with that axis of camera, whatever photos are collected from that air station will be called the tilted photographs. So these photographs will come under the category of oblique photographs. Illustration, what it is? It is the point from where the photo is taken in the air at the time of clip. It is a place, or it is the air station, or it is a place in the air from where the photo is taken at the time of clip. Then we have next is flying height. Elevation above the mean sea level from where the photo is clicked. It is height above mean sea level from where the photo is clicked, that is the flying height. So we will use these terms during some of the numericals. So we have seen some of the terms. As you will see, the scale of photograph. This is the mean sea level. This is the terrain. In this situation, the scale of the photograph can be written as S equals to F divided by H minus H, where we will write the H is nothing but the scale of photograph. Then the H is height of air station above mean sea level, height of air station above mean sea level. So it will be, if this is the air station, then this will be the height H above mean sea level. As it is the mean sea level, then H it is the height of terrain above mean sea level. So this will be, this we are taking the height, this terrain is the highest height, so we will take this as the height of terrain above mean sea level. There as the scale of photograph, H is the height of air station, H is the height of terrain above mean sea level, where F is, it is nothing but the focal length of camera by doing this we can find out the scale of photograph. Here we can remember one point, that the scale will not be constant always. You can remember that scale will not be, the scale of photograph will not remain the constant always. As you can see, that scale is a function of height, and this height will be changing from the time of time, so that the scale of photograph cannot remain constant. It is not a constant material. Therefore, every time we have to calculate the photograph, whatever scale we will be getting using this formula, that will be showing the scale of photograph at that particular height or at that particular level. So that this point we can remember that the scale of photograph will not remain constant. Other than this, if we are constructing if we are assuming a plane terrain, that means, or to say the perfectly plane terrain above the mean sea level, in that situation this height h will be equal to 0. If we are assuming this the plane terrain, perfectly plane terrain above the mean sea level, in that situation the height of terrain above mean sea level will be 0. In that situation, the scale of the photograph, this will be as equals to f divided by h minus h, where the h is nothing but the 0. So the scale of photograph will be as equals to f divided by the height, which is the height of air station above the mean sea level. This scale is well known as the datum scale. Here we can remember this point. Here is the scale of the photograph. This is generally known as the datum scale. Problem data for this problem, and we will try to see that what is given. You can see what we will read the question first of all. What is it? Vertical photographs were taken from the height of 3500 meters above the terrain with a camera of. Here you can remember that what it is written. So they are saying that here somewhere it is a point. This is the terrain where the was taken. Right, what they are saying, the vertical photographs were taken from the height of 3500 meters above the terrain. 3500 meters above the terrain, that means this distance is given as 3500 meters. Right. So we will write that. Okay, this we are just drawing, we are just writing the given data in a photograph. Above the terrain, the camera of 15 cm focal length. We can see that here the focal length is given as 15 cm. The focal length of the camera is given as 15 cm. We are asked to calculate the scale of the photograph. We are asked to calculate the scale of photograph. What is the scale of photograph? And this is what they given. Here we can see that this we can take it as the small h. Why? This is nothing but the height, that is the height of elevation above the mean sea level, that is capital H. So this and this height is nothing but the H minus H. So we have given directly the H minus H only in the problem. So we have given directly the H minus H equals to 3500 meters. And we will solve this, and we are asked to calculate the scale of photograph. We have just seen that the formula for calculating the scale of photograph is nothing but S equals to focal length divided by the difference in height, that is h minus h, where h is the height of air aspiration above the mean sea level, and a small h is the height of the line above mean sea level, and the difference of these two is directly given. The problem is 3.5 kilometer, while the focal length is given as 15 centimeter. First of all, we will convert this from 15 centimeter to meter. We can write it as 0.15 meter. Directly we will solve it here. S equals to 0.15 meter, which is in meter, as well as this is 3500 meter. So this is dimensionally balanced. If we solve this, this scale of photograph we will get as 0.34. This can be written as that the scale is 1 in 20,333.34. This is the scale of photograph 1 in 23,333.34. Sometimes we can take it as equivalent to, at the place of 0.34, we can take it as 334. Find out the determination of top of tower. For this we can use the formula, that is small h equals to x divided by r, where h we already know it is the height of terrain above mean sea level, we already know this, while the capital H it is nothing but the height of air station above mean sea level, and x it is the displacement, height of displacement level, why this is the height of air station above the mean sea level, small x it is nothing but the height of displacement, while r it is the radial of radial distance. Here we can see what is given in this problem. Let's write the given data. What is given? The vertical photographs were taken from the height of 3500 meter above the terrain with a camera of, this we have already solved, we will switch to the next problem. The distance of an image of a triangulation station 250 meter above the mean sea level from the principal point is 3.20 centimeter. We are asked to calculate the height of displacement if the flying height of the camera is 2000 meter, that means h is given as 2000 meter and this small h is given as 250 meter above the mean sea level, that means this is the height of the terrain, that is 250 meter and the third, that is the distance of image of triangulation station is given, that is for r is given as 3.20 centimeters and the fourth thing, we are asked to find out, calculate the height of displacement, that means the height of displacement, that is the, we generally take it as x, so we need to find out the x here. We have already discussed, we have discussed the formula just now that H equals to X into capital S divided by small r. In this problem, we are asked to find out the height of displacement or height displacement, that is nothing but this X. This need to calculate, right? That small h is also known, the capital H is known to us, as well as the small r is known to us, so that we can calculate. Just by reshifting this formula, we can calculate the height displacement, that is small x equals to small r into small s divided by the capital H. By using this formula, we can calculate the height displacement. Here you can see that we have given the small h is given into meters, small h is also given into meters, that is h and h both are given in meters, while r is given in centimeters. X equals to small r into small h while divided by capital H. You can see that this is in centimeter, this is in meter, while this is in meter. It will keep the data in the given units and we will get directly x in the centimeters. So directly we will move further with the given side, so with the given unit dimensions, 3.2 into a small h, that is 250 meter, divided by the capital H, that is 2000 meter. If we will solve this, we will get the height displacement as 0.4 centimeter. This will be equivalent to 4 mm. So for this particular case, the height of displacement is 4 mm. What we have done, or what was given first, the height of illustration above the mean sea level was given as 2000 meter. While the height of parent above the mean sea level was given as 250 meter, and this radial distance was given as 3.2 centimeter, and we were asked to find out the height of displacement. We already know this formula, so just by shifting this, we got this formula. We have arrived at this formula, and we have seen that the H and capital H was given in meter. So just if we keep the meter to meter, we can set and R, which is in centimeter, so that this height of displacement we will get directly in centimeter. So we will solve it in the similar way, and we got the X as 0.4 centimeter, that is equal to the 4 mm. So the height of displacement in this case is 4 mm. This is what the answer. Thank you.